Hello friends, myself Ilya R. Chandani, Assistant Professor from Department of Electronics, Walchen Institute of Technology, Solapur. Today we are going to see what are low frequency noises. So these are the learning outcomes. At the end of this topic, students are able to explain the effect of noise and analyze different types of noises. Types of frequency noises such as flicker noise, burst noise and avalanche noises. So first we are going to see again what is meant by or how a noise is defined. So as we know, noise may be defined as unwanted introduction of energy which tends to interfere with proper reception and reproduction of transmitted signal. So noise, hence it can limit the range of the systems. Noise may sometimes even force a reduction in the bandwidth of a system if it affects the sensitivity of the receiver also. Similarly, electrical noises are undesirable noises that fall within the passband of the signal. Passband, basically when we are considering the filter, then at these points the electrical noises may fall or get suppressed. Similarly, noise can also be called as a random energy that interfere with the information signal. In radio receiver, noises may basically produce a hiss noise in the loudspeaker at the output. As we have seen in our day-to-day life, we can see this particular point, that is, a hiss is produced in a loudspeaker when there is no input voice from the mic. So that particular hiss noise is called as it is the unwanted signal, which is called as the noise. So these are the sources of the noise. So as you can see, noise is basically further divided into two parts, internal and external. Similarly, the external is further divided as atmospheric noise, extraterrestrial noise, industrial. The internal noise basically defined further categorized as thermal noise and short noise. So as we have seen, atmospheric noise, basically they include cosmic noise and solar noises. Industrial noise, the turning on and off of the electrical machine, drilling, stamping, all these noises come under the industrial noise. Extraterrestrial noise, basically these are due to the these occur in the space due to the stars and the planets. Cosmic noise is one type of the noise which come under the extraterrestrial type of the noise. Similarly, internal noise, thermal noise, this particular thermal noise, as we have seen, it basically occurs due to the different electronic as well as electrical components in a circuit, such as resistors, capacitors, inductors, transistors, etc. And short noise, these are the noise which are occurring or which affect the low frequency type of the signals, and these are majorly affecting the lower frequency signals. So low frequency signals or flicker noise, active devices or integrated circuit devices, diode, transistors, etc. also exhibit a low frequency noise, which is frequency dependent, that is, it is not uniform, and hence this type of noise is called as a flicker noise. When we consider the spectrum density of the noise, here the noise spectrum density increases as the frequency decreases. Hence, it is given by 1 upon f into the noise. So, flicker noise is basically due to the impurities in the material, which in turn cause charge carrier fluctuations. So, charge carrier fluctuations is nothing but charge carrying components are electrons and the holes. So whenever there is a random movement between the electrons and the holes, these movement basically called fluctuations, and due to these fluctuations, the flicker noise gets introduced. In semiconductors, when we consider, flicker noise arises due to the fluctuation in carrier densities, such as whenever there is a current flow from whenever we are considering a current flow in a transistor from emitter base to emitter collector, at that particular point there is a flow of electrons as well as there is a flow of holes. Due to this flow in semiconductors, the flicker noise can get introduced. So second type of noise is the burst noise. This or popcorn, it is also called as popcorn noise. So burst noise is one kind of a low frequency noise. So low frequency noise observed in BJT is called as burst noise. So this noise basically occur in bipolar junction transistor, and hence it is called as burst noise. Noise appears as a series of burst at two or more levels. When present in an audio system, the noise produced popping sounds. When this particular noise occurs in audio system, then the noise produces a popping sound in the audio system. The spectral density for this, when it is considered, the spectral density increases as the frequency decreases. It is same as that of flicker noise. It is also a lower frequency noise. Partition noise, it occurs whenever there is a current, this total current, when it gets divided between two or more electrodes, and this results in random fluctuations in the division or during the division. So whenever we are considering a current which is flowing through a circuit and a point comes where the current needs to be get divided in the circuit. So during the division of the current at that particular point, as soon as the current gets divided, there are some fluctuations produced. There are some random fluctuations produced. Hence, these fluctuations cause noise to get introduced in the circuit. Such type of noise is called as the partition noise. The spectrum of partition noise is flat. It is spectrum means spectrum, noise spectrum density, or the noise spectrum for the partition noise, when it is considered, it is very much flat. The diode is said to be less noisy than that of transistor for the same reason. Hence, the third electrode makes more noise. So whenever we are considering a two terminal and a three terminal device, when we compare these two electronic components, then we find that the two terminal device, which is nothing but a diode, has less partition noise, whereas when we consider the three terminal electronic component, which is a transistor, it produces more partition noise, because in that the current gets divided into three different terminals. Hence, the partition noise is maximum. Avalanche noise. So it basically occurs due to avalanche, that is ionizing, where additional holes and electrons are produced, which in turn contribute to the ionization process. So whenever we are considering the density of electrons and holes, then in p type material and n type material, if there are some specific electrons and holes present, then due to the signal input, what exactly happens is there is the ionization takes place between the holes and the electrons, and hence due to this noise gets introduced. So the ionization process or the ionization phenomenon, basically it produces a noise which is called as the avalanche noise. Here the noise spikes are present, large noise spikes are present in the avalanche current. Sometimes these large noise spike currents are very much can cause a damage to the electrical circuit. The spectrum density of avalanche noise is flat as that of the burst noise, or it is also called as a popcorn noise. When we consider Zener diode, then in Zener diode, avalanche noise is majorly avoided. So intermodulation noise, or intermodulation distortion is the amplitude modulation of the signal containing two or more different frequencies in a system with non-linearities. So basically, the non-linearities occur in the frequencies itself. Modulating frequency is low and carry frequency is higher frequency. The intermodulation between each frequency component will form additional signal at frequencies that are not just at harmonic frequencies of either, but also at the sum and different frequency of the original, and are multiples of those sum and difference frequency. So whenever we are considering the modulation process, then there is a variation in the frequency with respect then there is a variations in carry frequency as that of the modulating signal frequency. Due to the variations, there are some additional frequencies produced which are basically called as harmonics, and these are produced due to the sum and the difference, that is variation. Variation is nothing but in that we are considering sum and difference of the frequencies between carrier and the modulating frequencies. So intermodulation is rarely desirable in radio and audio processing, as it creates unwanted suppressed emissions, often in the form of sideband. So the noise produced due to the intermodulation or variations in frequencies of carrier and modulating signal frequencies, this is called as the intermodulation noise. Impulse noise is generally only a minor annoyance for analog data. For example, when noise voice transmission is corrupted by short clicks and crackles with loss of intelligibility. However, impulse noise is the primary source of error in digital data communication. So whenever we consider a spike of energy, then that would destroy any voice data of 50 bits or 4800 BPS. So these are the references for you people for the further study. Thank you for watching the video.